phone call from Gavin. Lives at Baroran on the highway, just on my way back to Brisbane. And, yeah, he gave me a call, asked me if I could drop in. He's bought a gold rat sluice off Dustin McMurray from Gold Rat Engineering in Kippering in Brisbane. And, yeah, he's a bit unsure on whether he had it set up properly or what the go is. So we're going to drop in there, have a look, and see if we can't get it working properly for him. And he's got some dirt from a few places. We're going to run through it, see how we get on. Alrighty, let's go and have a look.
Yeah, that's it.
That's got something like this place.
Yeah, it's very yellow. Very smoky yellow.
That's that one in the son-in-law's farm, that's the ironstone one.
Yeah.
It'll go off. And that one.
This will be hot rock.
I don't know anything about it, but I found it. And
a bloke brought it to me, actually. He says, what do you think that is? And I said, I've no idea.
It's not bad looking. It's got a bit of ugliness about it. Yeah. Uglier the quartz, the better, mate.
Yeah, look, see the quartz right there like that. Look at that.
Yeah.
Amazing.
The area, I mean, probably not where you found that, but the area where it come from.
Now, what is that?
Well, that's quartz, but that is very yellow. It's very, I'll tell you, that'll be worth crushing. It's got a bit of pyrite in it too.
Yeah.
Which you see the pyrite's in it. You can just see the shiny little shiny flecks in it.
Yeah.
And pyrite, mate.
Well.
So pyrite and gold go together. So.
Well, that's 20 minutes down the road. Remember I was saying down this foreshores place?
Okay.
And there is a gold mine on the way down there. They got gold out of it.
Yeah.
But water beat them.
I've heard about that gold mine.
Jackass, it's called.
Jackass, that's right.
You drive right past it, 50 metres away from it going down to the,
yeah,
the thing. And I can get on all the properties around it, but I can't get on that one.
Level it out, like even the water flow out a bit, so we're going to have a go at that and run some pay dirt that he picked up from a property around the place. So yeah, might put a bit of lead in it and see if it catches that, no problem.
That's got number four, that's the second one I went to, and that's the third one I went to. It's all different stuff.
Different areas.
Oh, pretty much the same, all these gullies.
The different gullies, yeah.
Well, got him where the rocks, you know, drop down. And
well, that's a good even covering going through there. So, yeah. Yeah, these dream mats, they're unreal, mate. They, yeah, very, very good product. Very good product by Gold Rat, Dustin McMurray. So, yeah, just sprinkle them in there. How many pieces was there?
Eight.
Eight?
Yeah.
Eight small pieces of lead. Ideally about 8 degrees, as long as the water is running at an even flow through, about halfway up, well, not quite halfway up, but you might grab a scoop. Have you got a scoop?
Yeah, I've got one back in there.
Lost a little bit in the back there, but I don't know if you can see that, but it's running even and yeah, definitely taking it with it. I don't know if you can see that, but you can see that the vortex is swirling around, swirling, every hole swirling, working perfect. Beautiful.
Oh, the boat.
You want to go fishing and the battery will be flat.
The solar panel, I'm solar panel,
man. Oh, cool, there you go.
So it charges the gold up, man.
It's its job.
Yeah, well, that's what people didn't know how just watch Dave to stop and clean all this out, but just keep going slowly until you...
Yeah, once you do the bucket, probably take the mat out, clean it out in a bucket of water, and then pan it out, mate, so... See if there's any little pickers in there before we do that, but that lead's in there. So how many pieces of lead did you say?
Eight. One with nine new.
So hopefully, if we've got it set up properly and everything's running sweet, we should catch eight pieces of lead in the ripples. But yeah, they're a great little setup. Little clean-up sluices. We're out on the creek, you know, they're easy to carry, they're not heavy. Yeah, brilliant little setup. Everything seems to be doing its job here. Just hope there's a bit of gold in that pay dirt, mate. So how long you been mucking around in gold, mate? How long ago?
Yeah, a couple of years now.
Yeah?
Yeah. Fairly unsuccessful.
Now we'll see if we can remedy that. Yeah. But it's a good hobby, mate, and yeah, you can have a lot of fun.
Oh.
Kids love getting out in the bush, they love running around in the creeks and gosh. And it's better doing it with the kids doing the gold thing, because if you take them fishing, they throw rocks in the water and scare the fish away. Well, they can't scare the gold away, so.
I was doing the digging, the 7-year-old is doing the seven and getting the bucket.
That's awesome. Yeah, you know, it's a good family thing to do.
Take the bucket when he comes back this afternoon, or run one through and put it in.
But mate, I'm a big believer in, if you're finding gold, that's all well and good. But if your family's having fun, well, that's gold on its own, mate.
Yeah, good enjoying it. That's really, they're that keen on it. Their mother, that's one daughter, got four children, and two, she bought the daughter, believes that he texted her with the plate of mate, yep.
Oh, cool. Cool. Santa did.
They go with me up there when you get around picking up woods and stuff out around the farm there. And
yeah, they love it.
Me, they're digging holes everywhere. They're like bloody gophers.
Yeah.
Let them go.
Yeah, you know, I love taking my young black out, mate, and my daughter too, if she ever wants to come with me, but she's teenagers, you know what they're like.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, and mum and dad are paying the bum.
Yeah, but the young bloke, he loves it, so I take him every chance I get. You see that there, she's moving, see the rocks? The heavier, like the bigger stuff on top's moving through. Everything's swirling just the way it should be. I think we've got it on a pretty good angle there, mate. It seems to be on the good angle, and yeah, it's not a fast process with the little sluices. You've got to take your time and just feed it through. But yeah, working well. Everything's working the way it should be. A lot of material's moving through. I can see it moving through. I'm not sure if you guys can, but there's a lot of black sands. I'm starting to see a lot of black sands in the in each little dream mat vortex hole. I don't know what the technical term is for it. Get no big words out of me, kids. But no, it's working well. It's on a good gradient. Water flow's good. It's a good even flow right through. So and there's eight pieces of lead in this bucket. So hopefully we'll catch eight pieces of lead in those ripples. Lost a little bit out the back there, but that's wow. I know it's a black mat, but
hang on, look at it in your life.
I'm telling you, the amount of black sand in here is unreal. There's a lot of black sands in here. Be interesting pan.
Can we see any of that lead? Oh yeah, look. Lead. Probably not the best white here. Oh, there's a bit. I'm sure it could be pyrite. Oh, I've got a funny feeling I can see a little bit of gold there. Just in that second riffle in. But it's sitting on top, which makes me think it could be a bit of pyrite. Oh, there's a bit of, definitely a bit of quartz there. Looks like it's got something hanging off it there, right in that, which one is it? Right in the third hole along there, there's a little bit of quartz. It looks like it might have a little bit of gold on it.
Just two milk crates around, mate.
You can see the lead. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 that I can see there. I'm pretty sure I spotted a couple in here, so yeah, any decent sized pickers are going to get caught up the back here. There's another bit there, right at the just there.
Man, technology on.
So yeah, we pulled the mat out, put the spoils in here. We're now going to pan it out. We're just going to clean this stuff out of here back into the bucket, and then we'll put it all in the pan and see what we got.
He's filming now, mate.
Hey, all you gotta do is point. So righto, we've got the first bucket here. So we're gonna get all those heavies down the bottom, guys. Shake it up. Look at the black sand in it. Look at that. Definitely pyrites in there. Definitely got pyrites as well, so. Alrighty. Let's do it. It's a good pan, mate. What sort of pan is this, mate?
I bought that in Gympie. I don't know. It was a bloke used to be sell a bit of fossing and stuff in Gibby. I don't think he's there anymore.
There's got a little good riffles in it there.
There's a little blue one identical that goes with it, about half the size.
Get rid of all that lighter material off there. Geez, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of black sands in there, mate. A lot of black sands.
Well, I can find tons of that.
Okay, now we need some clean water, mate.
Right here.
Okay, we'll chuck a bit of clean water in there. Get rid of. Any more back down in the bottom there. Righto. Wave action going there. This is heavy stuff. Yeah, I can see the pyrites in it. Piece of lead just there, just floated out there. Maybe it's not.
See the lead starting to show itself there, mate. Some of this, get rid of some of this.
I'll come in around here. I've got my own shadow in the bloody thing too much.
If you really wanted to, you'd you'd probably better off come around this other side, mate. Buddy.
It's just that I'm shadowing.
No, that's all right, mate. Well, just get rid of that. Just get rid of some of that. Stuff that we've already pulled away there. All the heavies are still
up the top end here.
That's it. So now just put a little bit more clean water in there. I know they're chunky bits of lead, but just shows you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
There you go. They all in there, are they?
All there, mate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the dream mat, mate. It's probably not the best panning demonstration I've done, but
ooh.
I think I can see. Nah, it might have been pyrite, mate. Actually, I'll tell you what, we might just turn this off for a sec. You got a little bit of detergent. So yeah, a lot of black sands, and more's the pity, a fair bit of pyrite. So yeah, obviously that little piece I seen in the mat was a bit of pyrite, not gold, but in the sun it glinted. That's why they call it fool's gold, because it'll fool you. But yeah, a lot of pyrites. No gold in that one. Definitely pyrite, Gav. She's we put a little tiny bit of detergent in here. Any gold is gonna accumulate in the bottom run there, underneath the black sand. You won't get it up in here, and she changes colour, mate. You can flick it around and you can see she's bright one way and dull the next. So gold will never change its colour, no matter which way you look at it. So yeah, but mate, pyrite, black sands, there's got to be gold around there somewhere, I would think. But yeah, I'm going to head back to Brisbane now. Gav's going to run the rest of his dirt. Hopefully you'll get a bit of gold out of the rest of it. But yeah, you'll definitely know your gold, mate, if you do your panning properly. It'll all accumulate down in this bottom run right there. Yeah. And it won't move. Your black sand will come away and your gold will just be all sitting there in the bottom run.
Yeah. Very good. Thanks for that.
Yeah, good luck with it, mate.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Just thought I'd jump in quick, guys. Dustin McMurray from Gold Rat, he actually supplies gold diggers with sluices as well. And Ben O'Reilly from Gold Diggers sells the Gold Rat sluices down there at Mount Gravatt, 6/50, Frieda Street, Mount Gravatt. Now, when you buy a sluice, if you've never used a sluice before, especially these little clean-up sluices, mini clean-up sluices, they're great for fine gold. Well, Ben actually supplies, whoever buys a sluice, he actually supplies a bag, that's about an $8 bag there, of pay dirt with actual gold in it. So if you want to learn, you can run it through again and again and again and again and again. Just throw it in with a bucket of dirt, mix it all up, throw it through the sluice, get used to it, muck around with your grades on your sluice and catch all the dirt going through, run it through again and again and again until you know you've got it spot on. So yeah, give Ben a call. He'll you can get bigger bags too if you like. There's a bigger bag there. I'm not sure how much that one's worth, but I know these little fellas here, they're about $7.99, I think, and he throws one in with each sluice, as far as I know. Don't take my word for it, but I'm pretty sure he does. So yeah, and I'll just explain. I thought I'd throw this video through in between the old timers digs. I know I'm due for part two shortly. I'm just working on getting that finished. And I probably didn't go in depth with the sluicing on this. When we do the sluicing on the old timer tailings, I'll do a full setup and from start to finish. So yeah, alrighty guys, thanks for watching.
See you, Gav.
See you, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you very much.
See ya.
Okay.